Hello, this video is going to discuss the chi-square independence test. And for this, we're going to begin by discussing contingency tables, which put two variables together and look at the overlap between their categories. So we have a row by column contingency table, and it shows the observed frequencies for the two variables arranged in the rows and columns. And each intersection is a cell. Now the following table shows a random sample of 321 fatally injured passenger vehicle drivers by age and gender. So we're looking at the overlap of age and gender in this case. So we're going to wind up comparing our observed to some expected frequencies. So first we have to identify how we arrive at our expected frequencies for the contingency table. So, of course, we've got to assume that the two variables are independent for this test. So this is, what is a test of independence? You can use the contingency table to find the expectant frequency for each cell. And we do that by taking the sum of row R and the sum of column C and adjusting it by sample size, and that gives us our expected row-column frequency. So returning to our example, we're going to find the expected frequency for each cell from the intersection of gender and age. So for each male cell in the contingency table, assume the variables age and gender are independent. Let's find the expected. And there are 216 males. And then we have different numbers within each age category. And so if we take the overall number of males and multiply it by 45 and divide by the total sample, we get our expected frequency for the 16 to 20-year-old males. And that turns out to be 30.28. And then we repeat those steps for each age interval, multiplying the total number of males by the total number in each category of age, and then dividing that by the total sample size. So what we're doing with the chi-square independence test is seeing if one variable influences another. If they don't, then they are independent, hence the name independence test. So for the chi-square independence test to be used, we must meet the following. The observed frequencies must be obtained using a random sample. And each expected frequency must be greater than or equal to 5. If that doesn't happen, then we're not meeting the criteria. If the conditions are met, then the sampling distribution for the chi-square independence test is approximated by a chi-square distribution with R minus 1 times C minus 1 degrees of freedom, where those are the rows and columns. And you recall before with the goodness of fit, when we were looking at one variable, it was simply the categories. Well, each row and each column is a set of categories. So we're just subtracting one from each of those and taking the product. The test statistic down here, chi-square, it should look familiar. It's the same one we used for the goodness of fit, where we have the sum of the observed minus expected squared over the expected. And we'll go from there. So these are our steps. We first identify the claims and state them as hypotheses, our null and alternative. We identify a level of significance, our alpha, our degrees of freedom, R minus 1 times C minus 1, the critical value we get from our chi-square table based on the above criteria, and this will give us the rejection region. Calculate our test statistic, and there's our equation to test the test. To calculate the test statistic, rather. And based on what that statistic is relative to our rejection region, we will determine whether or not we reject the null or fail to reject the null, and then we interpret the original claim in that context. So returning to our example, we're going to identify alpha at 0.05, and we already calculated our expected frequencies previously, and we already noted the observed frequencies in each cell. So now we can come to the question, can we conclude that the driver's ages are related to gender in accidents? So the HO is that the driver's ages are independent, and the HA is that the driver's ages depend on gender. So that's the claim. And we've got our degrees of freedom here, equal to 5. And with 5 degrees of freedom at the 0.05 level, our cutoff for chi-square is 11.071, which we obtained from our chi-square table. And after we calculate our test statistic using our formula, here's the table. We take the sum of each of these rows and add them together. And what we get from that is 2.84, and that falls not within the rejection region, so we fail to reject the null hypothesis. There's not enough evidence at the 5% level to conclude that age is dependent on gender in such accidents.